The three of us left the comfort of our suburban homes to go to an environment that we've only heard about, but never seen up close. We flew down to Fort Lauderdale, where we met a tour guide who drove us into the wilderness of the Everglades, one of the largest wetlands in the world. All of us were shocked that such a vast wetland habitat existed, only 20 minutes from a major city. There was an overwhelming excitement when we saw our first alligator. Little did we know, the abundance of wildlife we were about to see throughout our trip would exceed our wildest dreams.
Ever since the days of old, men would search for wealth untold. They did for silver and for gold, and leave the empty holes. And way down south in the Everglades, where the black water rolls and the sawgrass waves, the eagles fly and the otters play in the land of the Seminole. So blow, Seminole wind, blow like you're never gonna blow again. I'm calling to you like a long lost friend, but I know who you are. And blow from the Okeechobee all the way up to Micanopy. Blow across the home of the Seminoles, the alligators and the gar. Progress came and took its toll, and in the name of flood control, they made their plans and they drained the land. Now the glades are going dry. And the last time I walked in the swamp, I sat up on a cypress stump. I listened close and I heard the ghost of Osceola cry.
The American alligator is the largest reptile in North America, with lengths exceeding 15 feet. They live in various bodies of fresh water from the Carolinas to the southern tip of Florida, then west to the mouth of the Rio Grande. Alligators are cold-blooded and spend most of the day basking in the sun to regulate their body temperatures. The alligator's main source of food is fish, but they will eat just about anything they can catch, including turtles, snakes, birds, raccoons, deer, and even other alligators. Alligators swim by tucking in their legs and using their powerful tail to propel them through the water. Although they appear slow and sluggish, they are quite capable of sudden bursts of speed. Alligators' mating season occurs mainly from mid-April through May, and the babies hatch from their eggs in mid-August.
One of the most threatened birds in the Everglades is the snail kite. When humans began to drain the Everglades, they killed off many apple snails, and because the kite feeds almost exclusively on these snails, their population greatly decreased. In 1972, there were only 65 snail kites left. They were put on the endangered species list in 1973. Since then, conservation efforts have increased their population to over 1,000. The snail kite flies low over the marshland and uses its excellent eyesight to spot apple snails. Then it swoops down and grabs the snail with its talons and pulls it out of its shell using its long, curved beak.
We boarded a boat on the coast of the Gulf of Mexico, the westernmost border of the Everglades. On our ride through the mangroves, we found several ospreys. The osprey, or fish hawk, is a medium-sized bird of prey, with lengths of almost 2 feet and a wingspan of about 4 feet. Ospreys primarily eat fish, and when they spot their prey, they plunge into the water and grab it with extremely sharp talons designed to grip fish.
Coming back to shore from our boat trip, a few playful bottlenose dolphins decided to catch a free ride in our wake. Bottlenose dolphins inhabit temperate and tropical waters throughout the world. They grow to over 8 feet long and can weigh close to 600 pounds. Dolphins can reach fast speeds using their powerful tail fluke and steering with their pectoral fins. Dolphins eat fish and hunt them using echolocation. Although they are entirely aquatic, dolphins are air-breathing mammals. Dolphins are one of the smartest animals in the world and often interact with boats and divers for entertainment.
We were not lucky enough to see a Florida panther in the wild, so we went to an Indian reservation where they had one in captivity. The panther is a subspecies of the mountain lion. It is smaller than its western relative and has longer legs and shorter hair. There were once over 1,000 panthers living in the Everglades, but due to overhunting and loss of habitat, they almost became extinct. The panther was placed on the endangered species list in 1967, but it is still extremely rare. Today, there is only 30 to 50 Florida panthers left. But new breeding experiments have been successful so far and give some hope for the future of this beautiful cat. Leaving the panther enclosure, we saw this curious raccoon climbing around the cages.
We left the Everglades and traveled south to Key Largo, where we found an abundance of small lizards called anoles. Anoles grow to about 6 inches long and use their quick speed to catch insects. These lizards are very unique because they can change their skin color from bright green to brown in order to camouflage with their surroundings. Male anoles have bright red throat patches, which they use to attract mates and to display territorial ownership.
Anoles weren't the only lizards we found in Key Largo. These iguanas have adapted to human development by using people's decks and patios to bask in the sun. Iguanas are large lizards that can grow up to lengths of about 6 feet. Young iguanas eat insects, but after a couple years, their diet mainly consists of vegetation. We also saw a variety of birds in Key Largo. Like the iguanas, many birds have adapted to human disturbance and are found in yards and public places, feeding on people's leftover food.
We left Key Largo and traveled south until we reached Big Pine Key, Home of the endangered key deer. The key deer habitat is a dry forest with underbrush so thick only the small deer can navigate through. Blue Hole, one of the only bodies of fresh water found in the Keys, is the primary source of water for the deer. But the key deer is not the only species that uses this pond. This 11-foot alligator resides in Blue Hole and probably reached its large size on a diet of unsuspecting key deer. A variety of fish also live in this pond. We found this deer right by the pond. On his neck is a radio collar, which biologists use to track and study the endangered species. Key deer were once abundant throughout many of the Keys, but due to human development, their numbers have dwindled to about 300. Key deer happen to be the smallest deer in the world, growing to be less than 3 feet tall. Hopefully, with the research of biologists, this unique species of deer can be saved from extinction.
Our trip to Florida was an amazing experience. All of us were fascinated that we could get so close to these exotic species we had never seen before. Seeing so many wild animals in their habitats opened our eyes to a wonderful world we had never experienced. We left Florida with three feelings that really stuck in our hearts. The first was how the vast wilderness of the Everglades took our breath away as we witnessed wildlife living in a pristine environment, free of human disturbance. Secondly, we were pleasantly surprised that a variety of species in the Keys could adapt and thrive in the midst of all the human development. Finally, we took home with us a sense of hope that the wildlife could be saved so that future generations would have a chance to experience what we saw. While we were getting high, someday you will find me caught beneath the landslide in a champagne supernova in the sky. Someday.